Every summer, students around Australia have the opportunity to be a part of a Student Life Summer Project. A summer project is a two-week mission experience aimed at training students to share their faith with their friends. Summer projects are fun, challenging, and instrumental in building movements of disciples here in Australia. This January, Newcastle, Macquarie, and the Sydney metro area will be combining to do a project on New South Wales' Central Coast.
I'm Nick.
And I'm Zach.
And we're the Evangelism Mythbusters. Well, guys, the deadline for summer project is only a month away, so make sure you get your applications in for project.
Hopefully, with the knowledge you've gained from Evangelism Mythbusters, paired with some experience at your campus, you'll be prepared for summer project.
That's right. Okay, Zach, why don't you tell us about today's myth for Evangelism Mythbusters?
Well, I'm excited about today's myth. Today's myth is good cop, bad cop. Ooh. And that myth is you can use a joint approach to make someone a Christian. If you have two people approach someone, one is really nice and loving and the other is very mean and condescending, that their emotions will be so confused that they couldn't help to become a Christian.
Well, that sounds very interesting. I'm excited to see the results of this test and maybe learn something about how to bring people to Jesus with it. Why don't you tell us how we're going to test this myth, Zach?
Well, for this week, we're going to use both of us in our testing. Mm-hmm. And you and I are going to approach some non-Christians around, and I'll be the bad cop, you can be the good cop, and we'll see if we can convert some people this week.
Well, that sounds great. Let's get into it.
Yeah.
G'day, mate. How you going?
Oh, hi.
I'm Nick.
Thomas.
Yeah. No, good to meet you, Thomas. Yeah. Can we have a chat?
Thomas, I'm Zach. And you just stand up, because you're not aware of the gravity. This is, boy, why are you standing? Sit down.
That's
you
right.
Can't handle this standing.
Sorry, right, Thomas. He's a bit grumpy at the moment, yes. See, we just wanted to have a chat with you about spiritual things, you know, see where you're at with stuff like that.
Right.
Me and my Zach, buddy Zach here, so...
Spiritual things? You better be all about them, son. You know what, Thomas? I want you to imagine something. Imagine we've got a little spider web here, and we got a little spider web, and there's a spider at the end of it, and it's being hung over hell. That's you. The only thing holding you above is a teeny tiny spider web. One little snip and eternity.
It's all right, Thomas. It's all right. Well, I'm pretty sure he's a Christian now, Zach. Maybe we can leave him alone. Yeah.
Son, you need to listen up. We got something important to talk to you about today. I'm Zach, and this is Nick.
Hey, g'day, mate. My name's Nick. It's all right. We're just here to chat to you about spiritual things.
So, chat?
Yeah.
More like tell you what's wrong with yourself.
See, the thing is, David, that we all make little mistakes sometimes. I'm sure you've made just a little itty-bitty mistake, like a total white lie or something like that.
Yeah, maybe 1 or 10.
Oh. Yeah, that's all right.
Little white lies? You think little white lies are right? Let me tell you about lying. I got these cats, Ananias and Sapphira. They're in the Bible. They lied. And you know what happened to them? Bam! God's knocked them straight dead, fool. Yeah.
You might fare better than those guys. I think you'll be all right.
I wouldn't count on it, son.
I've had enough of you, mate. Honestly.
Excuse me there, mate. Crap.
Are you serious? You again?
I think we lost him.
Yeah.
Hey, Zach, how's that going to affect your restraining order?
Yeah, we might need to delay some future tapings for a court date.
Yeah, okay. Well, anyway, what do you think about today's trials?
Well, in the first trial, we made someone cry. Mm. In the second trial, someone stormed off. In the third trial, well, we don't need to talk about that one.
Let's not go there. Okay, well, I think for today's myth, we can safely say that interrogation methods are great for a police interview, but for evangelism, maybe a good balance of grace and truth would be a more effective approach. Yeah, yeah.
That's so great. I think we can say this myth is officially busted.
Busted.
We do not recommend good cop, bad cop for evangelism.
No, good cop, bad cop.
Remember to sign up for Summer Project, and we'll see you again next time on Evangelism
Myth Busters.